down the line, I'm going to talk about Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge. Firstly, I just want to know, looking back at it over the years, so much has happened. Did you ever feel while making that film that it's ever going to reach this level of a success that it has reached?
I mean, we never had any doubts that it would do well. We really had no doubts that it would do well because the script was so fabulous and it was so well written. And
But tell me, was there ever any point during the making of the film, like say doing a particular scene or like dubbing, or maybe when you finally saw the film, that you felt this is something special, this is going to be something more than what you thought even in the beginning?
No, I always expected it to be. It lived up to my expectations, which is something that very rarely happens.
In a sense, you felt that
it's strange when you read a book, and you read a book and you imagine it. You have this particular image in your mind of what it's going to be like. And when you see the film, it almost always disappoints you because you always feel like you're, you know, hey, that could have been better or that could have been better. But when you saw Dilwale, it lived up to your imagination, which is saying so much for it. It is not, it's really an oddity. It's really a rare occurrence that it ever happens.
Because a lot of people who've heard the subject, a lot of people who've seen the film have always felt that, you know, that they always thought that, a lot of them have said that they've always thought this film will work wonders, will probably be the biggest hits ever, as it has been. But none of them in the beginning, when they heard the subject, really knew the extent to which it was going to go.
No, nobody knew the extent to which it could go. That's not something that anybody could expect. But we all expected it to be, at least I know for a fact, I can speak for speaking for myself, I would say that I expected it to be what it was.
Okay, so you did.
Definitely.
Okay, Kajal, this film, I feel, is also one of the reasons why you and Shah Rukh have become such a hit romantic couple. Why do you think that is?
Because it was one of the biggest hits that we had had together. And it came straight after Bazigar, so I think that also contributed to that. So people automatically started giving it kind of, giving us maybe together some kind of, you know, magical acceptance code or something like that.
No, but did you ever feel that maybe the characters of Raj and Simran like kind of even helped you to gain that chemistry on screen? I mean, the way they were written?
I think the characters worked for themselves. I mean, I don't think that we were ourselves at that point. I don't think that it was Kajol and Shah Rukh at that point of time. I mean, when I saw the film, I remember thinking to myself that, you know, I'd convinced myself that I was Simran, which was quite amazing.
Okay.
I mean, so at no point can I say that it did not help us and neither did it take away from us because we were not ourselves when we were doing that film.
Stint working with you. Whenever you're on the set, you're always full of life. I mean, you're always laughing, joking, you know, pulling pranks and eating my props. But whenever Adi used to yell at you, you used to promptly come back and deliver a perfect shot. And I've seen this happening all the time throughout, you know, even when you're doing your emotional scenes, you're always the same. You're always lively, always full of life and joking and screaming at each other. And I've always wondered, is this the way you prepare yourself for the character or is this just the way you are?
No, I think it's just the way I am. It's got nothing to do with any kind of preparation, actually. Actually, I get really depressed if I sat down on the sets and became depressed for every depressed scene or became, you know, emotional for every emotional scene.
No, but it's like unlike anybody I've ever seen before. Nobody ever does that. Even in like an emotional scene, you would probably try to prepare yourself or, you know, feel like, okay, I need to get into the scene. But you've been exactly the opposite. I mean, you were always laughing, joking, screaming, and you had to be like called and shouted at and say like, give the shot, and you used to give it and it was like perfect.
I don't think it's necessary. I think you just have to, you know, kind of do what you're paid for.
Okay. Okay, Kajal, suppose we could go back in time to those days when we were making Dilwale. Which particular time would you like to go back to, I mean, that you probably enjoyed the most?
When we were shooting Dilwale?
Yeah.
Definitely Switzerland.
Switzerland?
Yeah.
Why?
We had a ball in Switzerland. Everything. I can't imagine. We really had a ball in Switzerland. I mean, everything, every day of that schedule, there was something or the other happening. There was, I don't know, it was like we were pulling pranks on somebody or the other. We were just like, it was just amazing fun. I mean, every day.
It was fabulous. It was one of the best.
Yeah. It was really one of the best schedules.
I agree. But suppose you were given the choice of ever doing one scene again, like redoing it today. Which scene would you do?
I can't really think of, no, nothing that comes to mind, really. There's no scene that I would, but I would like to do the whole film again. Besides the point. But, no, not any particular scene, no. I think all the scenes had something very spontaneous about them and something very, unmistakably magical about them that cannot be redone.
Yeah, you don't want to touch them.
You don't want to touch them, leave it.
That's perfect. That's the way it is. Yeah, I know what
exactly.
You mean. But say, today, looking back, you know, after 6 years, looking back at the work you've done, looking back at the film, which is your favorite scene today when you think about it?
I think it would have to be the scene with Amrish Puri, where she's sitting and she's asking for permission to go for that thing. I don't know, there was something about that scene that was so natural. At the same time, it just felt very, very real to me. It really felt like, you know, what somebody probably had gone through. It was probably the only point in the film where I could say that I identified completely with her.
Bauji.
And in the beginning, we were doing your intro shots. You kept asking us, you know, when are we doing that scene? When are we doing that scene?
I really liked that scene. I thought it was... Yes. Oh, by the way, the one thing that I would change would be the short white skirt.
I
forgot
about
that.
Yes. Well, you look fabulous in it. I mean, I don't know why you should change it.
Yeah, right. Every male would say that.
Anyway, last question, Kajal. Dilwale has been a very special film for all of the people who's worked in it, you know, me and my family and everyone. I just wanted to know what it means to you as a film.
Dilwale meant a lot more to me than just a film, because at that point of time I was friendly with, I mean, you know, we were just, all of us were, you know, just so tightly knit. So it was more of an experience, really. It was more of a complete whole experience of... Just, I never felt like I left home. It was just like going from one home to another, and, you know, it was just different members of my family, really, that I was meeting. So it was just more of, it was just an experience. I can't explain it. It was really something else.
Okay, thanks a lot, Kajal. It's been great. I don't know if I'll ever get to share the same frame with you on film, but I've really enjoyed sharing this frame with you on video.
Definitely.
See you.
Thank you.
Shahrukh, good. How are you doing?
Good.
Okay, Shahrukh, you worked with Yash Raj Films even before Dilwale and even after Dilwale. But what I wanted to know was that when you were working in DDLJ, did you feel that it would reach this level of success that it has? I mean, today it's 6 years continuous running and still running in cinemas. Did you think it would ever reach this level?
You know, Yuri, when I did DDLJ, I was just, because we're doing this interview, I've tried to calculate. It's nearly more than half my career ago when I shot the film. It was at nearly 7 years ago, because 6 years have been running, 1 year before we were making it. And I never thought of, I didn't know what commercial success was. I didn't know how many weeks a film runs, how a film does. And whatever I know now was wrong. I mean, it was just a sort of a newcomer. You know, I'm not even from the film industry, so I didn't know trade figures, I didn't know how it works. So I never thought of it as how big a hit it would be. But when I was dubbing for the film, I really enjoyed, I had enjoyed making, you know, the second half a lot, because I found that very funny and I found it very emotional and nice. The first half I was very iffy about, I didn't know how it would go, you know. Okay. And when I started dubbing, I found the first half fantastic. And I remember calling Adi right from there and saying, Adi, you know, I like the second half. So I would never even, you know, it was never the question. The second half is nice and not nice. But the first half is so brilliant and so funny. And it was really, you know, I think, again, the first half, about 80% or 70% of the first half only has two characters, maybe, if I'm not mistaken. Just two people walking and talking, you know. It's quite like a on the road kind of a movie, you know.
That's
where very strange to happen at that time, or even after that, there's not been films like that. So I never thought how successful it would be. I didn't know, as you're telling me now, it's going to be 300 weeks. It's perhaps will be, I think, inshallah, the longest running film ever in the history of Indian cinema.
Which it is already.
It is, and I'm saying it will remain forever. I think we're very, very comfortable with each other. I always tell this to everyone. It's, I've hit her on the head at times when she's not doing a scene properly, if she's, when we started off. And I remember even in Dilwale, while we were doing the song, Ho Gaya Hai Tujhko To Pyar Sajna. I remember we were waiting for a shot and somebody has to cross the car. She has to cross the car while I'm sitting on the seat.
Yeah, I remember. On the bridge we did that.
And I remember she was not concentrating and she was shouting and all. So I took her to the side and shouted at her. I think there's a lot of comfort that we both share. We don't rehearse for a scene. We don't ever sit down and discuss a scene. We just let it be and trust each other so much. I think that's the reason, if it is ever going to be, I don't know if it's legendary or not, but that's the reason I think we just work out well in the film, in all the films that we've done, especially Dilwale, of course, made us a romantic pair. I mean, Dilwale has made me a romantic hero, which I'm still trying to get out of. So,
why are you trying to get out of it? I mean,
you know, I'd never done a love story before Dilwale. I never wanted to do love stories. I never wanted to go to college in films. I never wanted to come back and say, Mom, I'm a first IO. I never wanted to have a poor man, rich girl kind of a romance. I never wanted to have a romance. I remember giving my first interview where I said, look, I don't want to be in a film where the families have a problem and the boy says, I love you and I'll marry you and I'll run away with you and all. And then suddenly here was a film that said everything in reverse. And before this, I was the bad guy of Dar and Anjaam and Bazigar and Karan Arjun. I'd never done a straight on romantic film till 3 years of my career. And I remember Adi fooled me into it. I remember him telling me that he's going to make a film, I think, which was, if I'm not mistaken, called Ozar or Loha.
It was called Shastra. Shastra, yeah.
Right. So he fooled me into saying that I'm going to make that film. And then he came and narrated me the story of Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge. So it was anything but Shastra.
But so, you had some reservations initially of doing this film. Was it because of that? Because it was going to be...
No, I had no reservations. It's just that I don't react when I listen to stories. Okay. So I remember that Adi came to Nariadwala Bungalow. Hmm. And he came and narrated the story to me in a very colorful bedroom. And I listened to it and he says, look, when I was working with Adi and when you were also there, so for me it was more than Yashji, I was closer to you guys.
Yeah.
You know, because Yashji was senior and he had Sunny and Juhi and, you know, he was looking after them and they were senior actors working with me. For me, my friends and the people who made me happy on the sets was you and Adi. And I don't know if you remember or not, I told you whenever you do a film, I'll do it.
And, I remember you told me that.
Said, whatever wacky film you make.
I told you also about Ranga.
You told me a story about Saranga. So that I'll take you on whenever you want me to act in it. And I told Adi also. So for me, whatever Adi would have made, I would have done.
But you didn't immediately say that you're doing the film. I mean, when he narrated the subject, you did not immediately come and say that.
No, I think the confusion was that Adi felt that I'm going to react in a certain way.
Okay.
Okay, that I would cry or I would laugh or I would say, wow. And for me, it was, there's no need to tell me the story. I'm just going to do the film. Because I remember Yashji called me and said, oh, Adi was very disappointed. Are you uncomfortable when Javed Siddiqui came and he asked me? I said, no, I'm doing the film. There's no problem at all. I think it's just that I don't react to love stories. Because, you know, I do believe that love stories cannot be written alone. They have to be made by the belief of the person who's written it, who's directing it, and who's acting in it. You cannot just make a love story. Love stories are to be made with love. You know, they say legendary love stories, and a lot of people make love stories. I've done some love stories after that also. But love stories need to be made with a lot of love. And I think Dilwale had vouched for the fact that, whatever anyone may say, that Dilwale got made as it was being made.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know
if I can explain
a lot of the scenes, in fact, actually, with you and Anupam and Amrishji, on paper, they were actually nothing. And in fact, when you just started doing them, they just came alive. Made. Especially that Kabutar scene. It just came alive.
Yeah, that Kabutar scene was... Yeah. Actually, it came more alive with the dubbing. When we were doing it, trying to say, So the film just got made. And it was actually a montage. I was just supposed to come and then give. And the second one, we're friends. It was a musical montage.
Yeah.
So I think it was to get made there. And I had that feeling. So there was no point in me reacting. And I don't normally react. I mean, everyone says that when they narrate a story to me, it's very scary because I don't react at all.
But what happened after this film was also that Raj and Simran became romantic icons also. I just want to know, did it ever happen after the film released that anyone came to you and spoke about, you know, you as a character called Raj and spoke to you like that or as Raj?
You know, I'll tell you something, I'll let you on. Like, I meet some actors who sort of talk about themselves in third person and say, look, I became Raj, or I became Ravi, or I became Vijay, or I became Rahul. For me, Raj is Shah Rukh. And there are a lot of moments You know, a film is larger than life. Film is a little over the top than life. There are moments which perhaps it's not as happy in real life, or it's not as sad in real life at times. So those elements aside, there's a lot of things in Dilwale. Like I know a lot of girls and boys met me all over the world actually after Dilwale, who tell us, you know, Dilwale changed their lives. And you know, I want to be, I think I'm Raj, or you know, I found my Simran. Then I've met married couples who talk like this, that, you know, after seeing Dilwale, changed the way we look at our marriage because we remembered our romance and it was like this. I know of my friends and friends of friends who told me that they went on a in a train to fall in love. You know, so people have said things like that to me. And I can never turn to them and say, like a lot of people ask me, are you like Raj? And I say, yeah, I'm like Raj. Because I am Raj. I mean, there's no, I would never say that. Raj as a character will live in my memory, and Raj as a character was one of the most important characters I did. No, Raj is me, so there's no character. Yes, there are some Rahuls that I've done which would remain very strong with me. There might be, maybe the Raj Aryan of Mohabbatein will remain with me as a character, because that's not me. That's not like me.
Okay.
You know, but this Raj of Dilwale was
me.
So it is me, so there is no question of you know, has anyone come up, and I can't explain to people, yeah, that it's me. Yes, of course, there are some moments which I may never do in real life because I am shy and I may not do them. But because it's a film, I took the liberty. But I would do it with a girl that I would tease her in the morning and then feel bad that it, you know, it got pushed. I would do a Ruk Jao Dil Diwane.
And drop her in the end. You could go back in time and choose any one scene in that film and do it all over again. Which scene would you do it? And what would you do if you did it?
Look, my favorite scene in the film is very strange. Actually, the reason I did the film is for the just one line where Mr. Amrish Puri, is very strange that I do films for one line or one scene. And this film I did for a line which is not even mine. You know, something stays in my mind of every film. And I said, okay, I'll do it just for that. And mostly it is, you know, something to do with my role or my scene. But here was a film which I did it because Jaat Jaat Woh Apni Zindagi Jeele. You know, when Amrish Puri,
when he leaves her hand,
yeah. You know, and I envisaged it like that. I thought of it like that. And very seldom it happens that what you hear from the director, read in your scene, you go and enact on location. That was just like how I'd imagine it to be. And for me, throughout the film, I was just waiting.
अब मुझे एकदम छोटा सा इंसिडेंट है, कुछ लोग नहीं बिलीव करेंगे. मेरे एक दोस्त थे, बहुत बड़े एस्ट्रोलॉजर कह लो या फेस रीडिंग कह लो या कुछ कह लो, वो घर में बैठे थे मेरे और आदि आया वहां से, नमस्ते की उसने, ऐसे बहुत छोटा था. तो मैंने कहा इस बच्चे को म्यूजिक की बहुत समझ है. अरे मैंने कहा कोई म्यूजिक सिखा के पागल हो गया, ये तबला सीखता रहा, कुछ सीखता है, समझ गया. तो मेरे पास इसको म्यूजिक की बहुत समझ आ गई. तो मुझे लगा कि वो और कोई काम करेगा ही नहीं, बट आई वॉज अंदर से बहुत खुश था मैं. नहीं, मेरे बगैर प्रेशर डालने के, मेरे बगैर ये कहने के तू ये काम कर, अगर कोई बच्चा, क्योंकि जो कुछ मैं हूं आज इसी वजह से हूं कि फिल्म में काम करता हूं, डायरेक्शन करता हूं. जैसे कोई दुकानदार या कोई बिजनेसमैन समझता है कि मेरे बच्चे आके बिजनेस संभालेंगे, अगर ये डायरेक्टर बने तो मुझे बहुत खुशी होगी. और आज वो बन गया है. तो ये छोटी छोटी बातें बिगनिंग की थी, मुझे अभी भी याद आती हैं कि मुझे यकीन था कि ये बच्चा और कोई काम कर ही नहीं सकता.
Back to you. I remember you were the first person he narrated the subject to, and you of course loved it, and that gave him a lot of confidence. In fact, after that he went on to narrate it to the rest of the unit. But the reaction of the rest of the unit was not as one expected. What do you think was the reason for that?
Reason क्या था? मैंने शायद पहला जब आदि ने आइडिया सोचा था, बिल्कुल आइडिया फॉर्म, नो स्क्रिप्ट फॉर्म में, ही नेरेटेड मी आइडिया, आई वुड लाइक टू मेक अ सब्जेक्ट लाइक दिस, नो आई वुड लाइक टू मेक, ही सेज आई हैव वांटेड सब्जेक्ट लाइक दिस, ही थॉट आई मेक इट, ही वाज ऑलरेडी डायरेक्टर,
ओके,
ही आइडिया टोल्ड मी इट्स वेरी गुड आइडिया, बट ही सेड दैट यू आर नॉट एक्साइटेड अबाउट इट, यू से इट्स वेरी गुड, आई से आई थिंक the subject which needed me more than that is in your mind, I feel you are excited about it. I mean, he was only 22 and a half or 23, at that time telling him at that moment, Adi, I think you should direct this film. He was very excited. He said, Dad, give me some time, 2 to 3 months. जब भी स्क्रिप्ट कंप्लीट होता है तो फिर मैं आपको सुनाता हूँ. अभी तब भी आपको अच्छा लगे तब देखिए. अभी किसी से कोई बात मत करो, किसी को बताओ नहीं कि मैं डेट करूंगा या नहीं करूंगा, सब जो सुनता हूँ. वो 2-3-4 महीने बाद एक दिन आई रिमेम्बर इवन पैम वॉज नॉट इन बॉम्बे, शी वॉज इन लंडन. ही नेटिव सब्जेक्ट टू मी. जब मैं सब्जेक्ट सुना, जब एंड हुआ, देयर वर टीयर्स इन माय आईज. There are two reasons. Pehla reason ye tha ki I was feeling so proud of it. My son, who is only 22, 23 years old, he could write such a fantastic subject. And secondly, of course, it was so emotional that I couldn't help having tears in my eyes. To us wakt mere aur Adi ki ek definite confidence hogi, ye great subject hai, hum banayenge. Jo hamari pratha hai, jo hamara system hai. Before we start the film, so he made a subject of the whole unit. Means, cameraman, art director, writers, jo bhi. And unka reaction, ek bada ek lukewarm sa keh lijiye. Koi bolne ka, iska yaar wo hai, unko kaise hoga, love ki intensity hogi ki nahi hogi, climax mein, aisa kaise ho sakta hai, ki ek baap beti ka haath chhod de. तो मुझे उस पर सिर्फ एक मैं सिर्फ देख रहा था. आदि ऑफ कोर्स वाज ओवर कॉन्फिडेंट. उन किसी के रिएक्शन उसके ऊपर 1% असर नहीं किया. बट आई कुड ओनली फील दैट दे हर्ड द सब्जेक्ट, दे हैव नॉट गॉन बिहाइंड द राइटर और डायरेक्टर्स माइंड कि ये क्या करने वाला आदमी क्या है, इसके पीछे क्या है. सिर्फ एक आदमी जो नेक्स्ट टाइम सब्जेक्ट सुना, जब हम म्यूजिक शुरू करने वाले थे, मिस्टर बख्शी, आनंद बख्शी, इसे आदि बेटे तू जो सब्जेक्ट में सुनाया है अगर 50% उसका बनाएगा तो ये सुपर डुपर फिल्म है. अगर तो 100% बना दिया, पहला डायरेक्टर आदि ऐसे फील करता है तो, क्योंकि वो बहुत बेसिक आदमी है, कहते इज ए ग्रेट सब्जेक्ट, तो 50% बनाते हैं सुपर हिट फिल्म. तो किसी को सब्जेक्ट को अप्रिशिएट करने के लिए राइटर और डायरेक्टर के माइंड के पीछे जाना पड़ता है. एंड दैट्स वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट. आई थिंक इट्स इम्पॉसिबल.
टेल मी समथिंग. आई रिमेंबर the first time when we all saw the film together, it was in Madras. I remember the copy had come out. What was your first feeling after seeing your son's first film, the first copy? What did you feel like?
I think I first time I saw this film in Rajgaon, when there was no dubbing, there was no background music, there was no climax even. He started shooting, lekin abhi edit nahi kiya tha. Mujhe laga bahut achhi film hai. As you say, फर्स्ट टाइम जब मद्रास में फिल्म देखी आफ्टर बैकग्राउंड, बिकॉज हमने री रिकॉर्डिंग मद्रास में करवाई थी. इट वॉज हमारी कंपनी की फर्स्ट डॉल्बी डिजिटल फिल्म थी. तो मुझे लगा ये वी हैव मेड अ ग्रेट फिल्म विद ग्रेट इमोशंस. उसका प्रूफ मुझे तब मिला कि मद्रास के जो ऑपरेटर थे जो हिंदी नहीं जानते, देखो री रिकॉर्डिंग में पीछे सारे देखी, दे केम टू मी बोले साहब इस फिल्म को आप तेलुगु में डबिंग करो, ये बहुत चलेगी. हम हिंदी में देखते हैं, आधी फिल्म समझ आती है, पर हम तब को हमको दिल को लगता है आप तेलुगु में डबिंग करो. तो दैट वाज ओनली वेरी नियर, बट एक महीना रिलीज किया था, प्रिंट निकाला, बॉम्बे लेके आया फॉर सेंसर एंड रिलीज कर दी. तो मैंने आके तेलुगु की रिलीज बंद कर दी, डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर जो पिक्चर दी थी वापस ले ली. आई रिलीज द फिल्म, डब इट एंड देन रिलीज. And I think in Telugu, when I dubbed it, it was as big a hit as in Hindi.
Tell me something, Dad. What is your experience of making this film? I mean, throughout this film, what has the experience been of making this film?
It's not experience. It's a, I don't have the words to put it. Because, say, har parinda feel karta hai. एक बर्ड फ्लाई करता है, अपने बच्चे को ऊपर बिठा के फ्लाई करता है. ही फील्स सो हैप्पी व्हेन हिज चाइल्ड और दिस लिटिल बर्ड फ्लाइज ऑन हिज ओन विंग्स. उस एक्सपीरियंस का, उस फीलिंग का को वर्ड देना बहुत मुश्किल होता है. बिकॉज उस दिन मुझे लगा जब मैं पिक्चर देखी उसके बाद उसकी सक्सेस हो गई. जब आदमी पिक्चर देखता जाइए तो फील करता ये पिक्चर बहुत बड़ी हिट होगी. उस बहुत बड़ी का वर्ड्स तो नहीं होते, सिल्वर जुबली हो जाएगी, गोल्डन जुबली हो जाएगी, बस हमको लगा भाई बहुत मामला फर्स्ट क्लास है. कि जो भी मैंने सोचा था, जो भी मैं नहीं भी सोचा था, मुझे लगता वो पूरा हो जाएगा.
That you and I will be sitting after 300 weeks and talking about the success of the film. Do you ever feel it would reach this level of a success that it has?
First of all, I never thought in my wildest dreams कि ये फिल्म 300 वीक्स करेगी. क्योंकि 300 वीक्स 6 साल होते हैं. आज तक कोई मेरा ख्याल है जहाँ तक मुझे याद है किसी फिल्म ने 6 साल नहीं किए. और ये गिन 6 साल हुए, 300 बाकी पिक्चर चलेगी और कितनी चलेगी मुझे पता नहीं, क्योंकि अभी भी बहुत अच्छी चल रही है. और दूसरा, जब ये फिल्म बनी थी आज से समझो 6 साल पहले, यू आर नॉट सच ए बिग बॉय, कभी मैंने सोचा नहीं था कि ये पिक्चर 300 हो जाएगी और उदय सिटिंग बिफोर मी इंटरव्यूइंग मी. सो इट्स अ ग्रेट मोमेंट फॉर मी. आदि की पिक्चर 300 वीक्स कर रही है एंड उदय इज इंटरव्यूइंग एंड दिस इंटरव्यू विल बी सीन बाय ऑल ऑफ द वर्ल्ड.
That also, Dilwale, I think, has made a major difference to us as a family, also as a company. In your words, what difference do you think it has made to Yash Raj Films and to us?
मेरी जिंदगी में पिक्चरें बहुत बनाई हैं, भगवान की बहुत कृपा रही, हिट भी हुई हैं, पैसे भी लाए हैं, इज्जत भी दी है. But with Dilwale, we started saying dreams. We means as a family, as a company. दिलवाले के बाद जो कुछ आज किया है, दिलवाले के बाद सोचा हमने कि हम अपने डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफिस खोले हैं, बॉम्बे में खोले हैं, यूके में खोले हैं, यूएसए में खोले हैं और फिल्में बनाए. दिलवाले से जब लगा कि भगवान इज वेरी काइंड टू अस, मनी इज कमिंग. क्योंकि एक फिल्म मेकर और क्या ड्रीम कर सकता है, ही कांट से मैं टेक्सटाइल मिल खोल दूंगा. तो अभी ड्रीम विजन के नहीं, वन डे वी शुड ओन आवर ओन स्टूडियो एंड वो ड्रीम भी बहुत जल्दी पूरा होने वाला है. बिकॉज वी आर स्टार्टिंग द स्टूडियो कंस्ट्रक्शन वेरी सून, आई थिंक लेस देन अ मंथ टाइम. तो दिल वाले अपार्ट फ्रॉम गिविंग नेम फेम एंड मनी ब्रॉट सो मेनी ड्रीम इन टू अवर माइंड्स एज ए फैमिली एज ए कंसर्न एंड गॉड इज काइंड, वी विल फिल फॉर दोस ड्रीम्स.
From that whole period, the whole 1 year of making the film, which period would you want to go back to? I mean, which one did you enjoy the most?
I have been always a producer director before Dilwale. Film which I produced also is my policy. क्योंकि मैं किसी director को picture दे दूँ direction करने के लिए, उससे पहले मैं कुछ भी करूँ, script पे काम करूँ, music पे काम करूँ, casting पे काम करूँ, पर मैं जाके किसी director के set पे एक अजीब सी dictation power नहीं बैठूँगा कभी. मैं गया नहीं कभी set किसी पे. But this being Adi's first film, I wanted to be part of it, not on the creation side at all. I have no 1% contribution making of Dilwale. But no, I say, my son is making this film, so usko kisi cheez mein duniya mein kami nahi honi chahiye. Usko root padhe, to production manager pura nahi kare. So I was generally a producer and a production manager, you say. 1 month we spent in England and Switzerland. Hum pehle England gaye, एक हफ्ता सारी लोकेशंस फाइनल की, वी वेंट टू स्विट्जरलैंड, शॉट फॉर 10-15 डेज, केम बैक टू इंग्लैंड, देन इंग्लैंड का पोर्शन किया. ऑल दोस डेज आई वाज वर्किंग एज ए प्रोड्यूसर आल्सो, एज ए प्रोडक्शन मैनेजर आल्सो. आदि के मुंह से अगर कुछ निकला कि मुझे एक मर्सिडीज चाहिए, मुझे एक हेलीकॉप्टर चाहिए, मुझे एक प्लेन ग्लाइडर प्लेन चाहिए, जो कुछ चाहिए, मैं उसको कोई कमी नहीं दूंगा. दैट्स द रीजन. उस वक्त ये पहली पिक्चर थी जिसका मैंने किसी से फाइनेंस नहीं लिया. आई पुट अप ऑल माई ओन सोर्सेज एंड रिसोर्सेज. दूसरा आदमी फाइनेंस करेगा, मैं स्विट्जरलैंड जा रहा हूँ, ये नया डायरेक्टर है, ये कैसे पैसे वेस्ट कर रहे हैं. मैं कहता नहीं, मेरे बेटे को कोई हैंडीकैप नहीं होगा, मैं अपनी पिक्चर टीवी बेचूं, मैं अपनी पिक्चर किसी जगह पैसे निकालू, पैसे रिसोर्सेज इकट्ठे करके. और उसका बहुत डबल ट्रिपल फायदा हुआ. कोई फाइनेंसर नहीं था, कोई किसी से बैंक से पैसे लिए, and God was so kind. So I enjoyed that moment. Aaj bhi mohabbat jab banayi mein thi, that Adi like the film, just to be on the set with Adi watching him, I feel so happy.
Adi doesn't like to ever come in front of a camera and talk, but you as a director, which moment or scene or song do you think was Adi's best work in Dilwale?
Generally, jo log bolte hain, bahut se glamorous song hote hain, romantic song hote hain, dance song hote hain. But ek gana jo picture mein tha, Ghar Aaja Pardesi. Why? Because I was in the process of that song. He had clear his mind. ये गाना कैसे शुरू होगा, क्या क्या शॉर्ट्स जहाँ आएंगे, द होल पिक्चर. ये नहीं कि पहले गाना बन गया, गाना लिखा गया, गाना कंपोज हो गया, उस गाने को पिक्चर. नो, ही हैड ईच एवरी शॉट इन हिज माइंड. सारी पिक्चर में गाना आता है कि मैं कहाँ कहाँ यूज करूँगा, मुझे कहाँ कहाँ कैसे थॉट चाहिए. बिकॉज उसने वो देखा नहीं हुआ पंजाब, जो देखा बच्चों के साथ हमारे साथ, तो उस मोमेंट को वो लेके आया वहां. और दो सीन्स जो थे बहुत बहुत मुझे इम्प्रेस किए. एक सीन नेचुरली बहुत डिफिकल्ट सीन था, किसी डायरेक्टर के लिए भी क्लाइमेक्स सीन. इट वॉज मोर देन 4 to 5 minutes. एक आदमी बोल रहा है, बाकी सब चुप खड़े हैं. इवन आदि मायसेल्फ वी वर ऑल स्केयर्ड कि दिस सीन शुड वर्क. दिस सीन पे सारी पिक्चर डिपेंड करती है. आदि ने, मुझे याद है, एक दिन पहले सिर्फ उस सीन के रिहर्सल की, सारे आर्टिस्ट के साथ, कैमरे के साथ, कि मैं ऐसा ऐसा मूवमेंट करूंगा. और दैट सीन कम आउट ब्रिलियंटली. एंड जब पिक्चर लगी भी, वो थिएटर में गया सिर्फ वो सीन देखने के लिए. अगर वो सीन काम कर गया, किसी कोई डिस्टर्बेंस नहीं है, तो हम पार निकल गए. एक पिक्चर में छोटा सीन है, बहुत छोटा सीन है, बट दैट आई थिंक इज वंडरफुली रिटन एंड वंडरफुली इनेक्टेड. बिटवीन फ्रीदा जलाल एंड काजोल, जहां वह बोलती है एज ए मदर, बेटे औरत की जिंदगी जैसी होती है, कोई माँ की बहन, जब भी कुर्बानी देनी पड़ती है औरत को देनी पड़ती है. मेरे हिसाब से ये थॉट, एक छोटे से बच्चे जिसने भी औरत को देख, जो शादीशुदा नहीं है, जो कुछ नहीं किया, वो थॉट आना, इस वेरी बहुत बहुत सिंपली पिक्चराइज किया हुआ है. पिक्चर के सीन की सिंपली या गिमिकली पिक्चराइज करने की दूसरी ब्यूटी होती है. द सीन शुड कन्वे टू द ऑडियंस व्हिच बी कन्वे. मुझे दोनों सीन बहुत अच्छे लगते हैं.
दैट्स ग्रेट. ओके, फाइनली आई वांटेड टू आस्क यू, व्हाट इज द वन मोस्ट स्पेशल थिंग फॉर यू अबाउट दिलवाले?
जस्ट दिलवाले इज द मेजर थिंग, इज द टर्निंग पॉइंट ऑफ आवर कंसर्न. आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू के पहले पिक्चर भी हिट हुई है, लेकिन जितनी आज हम भविष्य सोच रहे हैं, आज हम सोच रहे हैं ये करने वाले हैं, फ्रॉम 95 अक्टूबर पिक्चर वॉज रिलीज टिल 2001 आ गया है. जितना कुछ हुआ है और होने वाला है इस DDLJ, वी कॉल DDLJ. क्या है कि मुझे आप आराम से बैठ सोच सकता हूं. ऑफकोर्स आई नो I would like to die with my boots on as long as I'm live. I do one working. I'm happy only when I'm working. But ये कहीं back of my mind अब हो गया है. ये छोटा सा एक जो पौधा बनाया था यशराज फिल्म का, आज जो 30 साल हो गए हैं, वो इन सेफ हैंड्स है. आदित्य चोपड़ा एंड यू उदय, आई नो आई नॉट टू वरी अबाउट दिस थिंग कि मैं बहुत मेहनत से काम किया है, वो एक छोटा सा पौधा, छोटा सा पेड़ बन गया है, लेकिन बहुत कुछ होना है. लेकिन मुझे लगता है ये बहुत सेफ हैंड्स में है, क्योंकि हमारी सबकी इंटेंशंस है अच्छा काम करने की. वी डोंट वांट टू डू एनी कॉम्प्रोमाइज विद वर्क, और हम वो करते रहेंगे, और गॉड विल बी काइंड टू अस, आई एम श्योर अबाउट इट.
Thank you so much, Dad. It was great talking to you.
All the best.
And you hope thanks. Maybe another 300 weeks later we can sit again and talk about it again.
Definitely, at least I think the picture is going as is running. Kab tak chale pata nahi, kyunki bahut acha business kar rahi hai and I'm very happy.
Thank you, Dad.
Thank you. Thanks. All the best.
कहानी सुनाने जा रही हूँ, सुनोगी? इस कहानी में एक लड़का है राहुल और एक लड़की है अंजलि। वो लड़ते थे, झगड़ते थे, लेकिन फिर भी वो एक दूसरे के बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स थे।
फिर क्या हुआ?
फिर कुछ कुछ हो गया।
The film is about feelings that you have during love, feelings that you have in relationships, feelings that cannot perhaps sometimes be described by words.
If you translate it into English, it sounds like something happens.
मुझे तो बहुत ही अच्छा लगा क्योंकि ये फिल्म के साथ मैच करती है।
कुछ कुछ होने लगता है जब आप टाइटल सुनते हैं तो आपको भी कुछ कुछ होता है।
कुछ कुछ नहीं होता है इस पिक्चर में, इतना कुछ होता है कि मैं बता नहीं सकता हूँ।
वेरी प्लेजेंट, वेरी रोमांटिक,
इट हैज अ वेरी म्यूजिकल साउंड टू इट।
एक गुदगुदी का एहसास, एक मुस्कुराहट, एक वार्मथ की फीलिंग आई।
द स्वीट रोमांटिक फिल्म, यू नो, यंग।
एक्चुअली वेरी बैड विद टाइटल्स, आई डिड नॉट लाइक दिलवाले दुल्हन ले जाएंगे, आई डिडंट लाइक हम आपके कौन से टाइटल्स, सो आई थिंक ही वाज वेरी हैप्पी दैट आई डिडंट लाइक द टाइटल बिकॉज़ ऑल दीस फिल्म्स हैव बीन सुपर हिट्स, सो आई थिंक आई एम रॉन्ग विद टाइटल्स।
जब उसने मुझे बताया कि कुछ कुछ होता है और जब स्टोरी सुनाई तो उसके बिल्कुल टाइटल सूट करता था उस टाइटल।
अमेजिंग टाइटल, टोटली कूल, साउंड्स गुड,
द टाइटल इज वेरी गुड।
सुनकर कुछ कुछ होता है,
कुछ कुछ होता है,
कुछ कुछ होता है।
कैरेक्टर आई एम प्लेइंग, जो कैरेक्टर किरदार है वो उसका नाम राहुल है।
देयर वाज अ लॉट मोर टू इट देन जस्ट मी।
जब करण ने मुझे सब्जेक्ट नरेट किया था तो मुझे टीना का कैरेक्टर इतना पसंद आया कि मैंने करण को बोला कि आई थिंक ओनली आई शुड डू दिस।
कुछ कुछ होता है a film completely based, done, enacted, performed, created and thought of as a Karan Johar film, I think. And I think easily one of the best writer-directors at least that I've worked with.
Sharuk, close your eyes for some time. Your last place to go.
It was very sweet actually because, you know, I knew him as a friend. I knew him on a social basis earlier. And to suddenly see him all working and all professional and, you know, really knows his own mind kind of thing. It was great actually.
He used to really explain to me the scene so well that like I wish that Karan could do my part, you know, more than me.
Very beautiful experience to work with him. Isse aap bachpan se jante ho.
He is very meticulous, he is very sure of what he is doing and he has made an excellent film.
It was a pleasure working with him.
Actually, I thought that I could bully him and make him do things my way, but Karan is a very, very strict director.
He's got a very big heart. He loves spending on his films, and he loves his dream to work with for any costume designer.
I will not mince words and say that today he will be, after this picture is released, he will be considered as one of the top directors of this country, which I'm sure and I'm proud of the